Welcome to the Trading Post. You're live on the air.
Hi.
Hey.
I'd like to know how come we only have lawyers in the government.
Well, you know, that's an interesting question. We have lawyers in the government because the people themselves are intimidated, and the lawyers are not. And so the lawyers who know how to manipulate the law and use the law and find the loopholes and control by the use of the law, they feel confident going into the offices of politics. Whereas common sense people, you know, they don't want to be bothered by it because I think that we see it's just a bunch of, you know, politics.
Well, I think also is the fact that the web is spun so tight now that being a lawyer is kind of a fallback on that, where you can say I can understand the web and I can play in this game, as opposed to the average citizen who can't.
Well, you know, and let's put lawyers in context. And if you go back in history, lawyers were the priests. The lawyers were the ones that maintained the law, and the kings relied upon the priests, their council. Those were the lawyers. And if you even go back into the book of the Bible and you find out that the Levites were the priests, and they were the lawyers. So the lawyers are the priests of this system. So it's only natural that the priests would migrate into the offices of politics. But the danger of this is that we've elevated humanism into a religion, and these lawyers are facilitating the doctrine of humanism, which is not compatible with most people that are spiritual.
Let's go back to the humanism aspect. Explain that a little bit more for
man
us.
Man is God. There's no nothing above this planet. There's no higher power. There's no natural order. There's no natural law. Man is it. And if man hasn't discovered it, it doesn't exist, which is about as arrogant a position as you can come up with. The early scientists were killed or persecuted by the church whenever they would go and make a new scientific discovery. It was because the church had the final say in what is reality. Now, this so-called church was not a true church at all. They were just a regimentation of religious opinion that had the final say, and they used the force and the threat of death to maintain control over the people. And this is ultimately what American pilgrims wanted to get away from England. They wanted to get away from that religious hierarchy that told them what truth is, irrespective of science and irrespective of the principles of love and the need to be free. So, you know, when we talk about the church, and this is a real uncomfortable place for most people, humanism has become the state religion. And in the humanist philosophy, the government is God, and that's the bottom line. And so we're operating in a humanist environment by thinking that all we need to do is get the right people elected into office, so they'll pass the right laws, so we'll get back to some semblance of normalcy. Failing to realize that more laws is not going to make a difference. So what's the point of electing more officials to go in and make more laws? Obviously, doing the same thing over and over again has not proven to be conducive to freedom. It's only it's proving to be conducive to more slavery and more burden on the people, on the people's pocketbooks.
Let's talk about anarchy. Don't you worry about the fact that this could lead to anarchy?
You know, the problem with freedom is it borders on anarchy. You can't remove the gospel from the foundation of America and have semblance of order. The true order comes out of a heart of love and respect for our fellow human beings. If we have true allegiance in this country, my allegiance belongs to you, Jim. My allegiance belongs to my neighbor. My allegiance belongs to my community, not to some artificial contrivance called government represents itself as my savior and my king. My true allegiance is my love for my fellow man, my love for my neighbor. And if we remove that from the equation, no amount of law is going to restrain my conduct. If I'm not motivated by love and integrity and honor and respect and personal accountability, if I'm not motivated by those things, law is not going to keep me in check.